Well, on to politics now. Pipe dream or reality? As 2014 draws closer, political circles are abuzz with talk of numerically significant formations, not just of a third front, but also of a federal front, a fourth front perhaps. So are we now looking at a repeat of 1996? And if we are, is it a desirable outcome?
It's been talked about. It's been dismissed as frequently as it's been asserted. Murmurs of a non-Congress, non-BJP political alternative on the national stage are once again out in the open. But is the third front just a pipe dream?
Let's look at the third front, led by Mulayam Singh, the left backing him, the JDU. If they align with the third front, overall, all the regional satraps will be able to cobble up only about 110 seats. Now, if they align with the BJP, who are projected to get about 141, they get close to majority, but they're still about 20-odd seats short, about 21 seats. Will Jayalalitha jump in to help? We have to see. With the Congress, it's a no-go. 223 seats is what is the projection that they would be able to cobble up together along with the Congress, well short of a majority.
While the Samajwadi Party says an alternative is impossible without them,
anti-Congress, anti-BJP, jab kabhi bhi morcha hoga ya koi taakat hogi, aur secular agar hogi, तो उसके समर्थन में समाजवादी पार्टी काम करेगी। अब किस रूप में क्या होगा ये अभी कह पाना मुश्किल है, लेकिन देश की जनता ये चाहती है कि कोई दल, कोई ताकत, कोई फ्रंट ऐसा बने जो कांग्रेस और बीजेपी के अलावा हो और सेकुलर फ्रंट हो।
ममता बनर्जी हैज मडीड द वाटर्स फर्दर, ब्रिंगिंग अप टॉक्स ऑफ अ फेडरल फ्रंट।
Let's take a look at the federal front. Championed by Mamata Banerjee, you have the JDU who have the option. Let's put the JDU in. AIADMK, Jayalalitha comes into the mix. Mayawati comes into the mix. We don't know how many seats she would get, but she would align with the Mamata Banerjee combined. Overall, they will be able to cobble up quite a sizable number. 152 compared to 102 the last time around. 50 plus seats. That's a sizable gain. Now, if they were to align with the BJP, they are in clear majority, a win-win situation for both sides.
But while Nitish Kumar has been in talks with Mamata and Naveen Patnaik, all the while baiting the BJP, will the JDU actually bite the bullet?
Our leader, Mr. Nitish Kumar, has also responded to it. Let's see if that happens and maybe we can talk about it. But I think it's too premature to talk about that right now. Given the experience in our country in the past, never ever any third front has really worked, because there are parties of different ideologies, there are leaders with different backgrounds.
While some are calling it the coming together of anti-Modi forces, in India of 2013, can 10 parties or more come together and secure our future?
Now, alternate program is what we are emphasizing on. They are emphasizing on a collection and a conglomeration of parties in order to muster up a majority. We don't believe in just the numerical majority being mustered up, because what is the alternative going to do?
There is no third front in the country. There is no any existence.
They must sit together, whatever may be their differences, whatever may be their differences, in the interest of this nation. There must be an alternative to Congress and BJP.
The Congress and BJP believe there cannot be an alternative at this point.
But I don't think the people of India are in any manner even prepared to give it a thought.
Many states which are being governed by non-UPA parties are trying to understand how best they can assert their interests and aspirations. There's nothing wrong with it.
But with pollsters predicting a verdict like 1996, will regional parties come together despite differences to form a non-Congress, non-BJP government? And if they do, will this mix be able to achieve any semblance of stability? Bureau Report, Times Now.